by faith we see the hand of God.
Good morning and happy Tuesday to you. Welcome to the Chester ARP Church Devotional Podcast. I'm Clint Davis, your host. Thank you for being with us. We turn our attention to Psalm 126 this morning as we think about the Psalms and the Psalms of Ascent, in particular the last couple weeks. The Psalms of Ascent were songs sung by pilgrims on their way to Jerusalem and while they were in Jerusalem as they were there to worship their God who sits on high. Psalm 126 is a psalm that reminds us that God does great and mighty things. His power is a great and unlimited power. It's a power that conquers death. It's also a power that frees us from our sin, especially sin's captive hold on our hearts. The Apostle Paul in Romans chapter 5 and chapter 6 talks about how sin has held us captive, that we are enslaved to sin. But through faith in the Lord Jesus Christ, and by attaching ourselves to Him in His life, death, and resurrection, through faith, we receive His power that frees us from our sin. It breaks the captive's power of sin in our lives. It's a story that reminds us of the Exodus in the book of Exodus, a story that reminds us of the time when the exiles of Israel returned home, of Judah returned to Jerusalem to worship God and to establish their kingdom. God had broken them free from their captives' hands. In a very literal sense, those nations were freed, those people were freed. And that is a beautiful picture and a beautiful reality that points us to a greater freedom that comes through the Lord Jesus Christ for each one of us. And so as we think about Psalm 126, and perhaps as we may sing it to ourselves, or certainly read it, we think about how God restored the fortunes of Zion. He restored the fortunes of His people. And then we beg Him and plead with Him to restore our fortunes to us once again, to restore the joy of our salvation, much like the psalmist in Psalm 51. As King David cried out to the Lord, "Restore unto me the joy of my salvation. Restore unto me the joy of thy salvation." What he means is, "I've sinned and fallen short of your glory. Forgive me, pardon me for my iniquities, and restore to me the joy that comes from walking with you." You see, when God saves you from your sins, when God saved me, He didn't simply forgive me. He restored me. He didn't simply forgive you. He restored you in His grace to a right relationship with Him. God's power is mighty in that it breaks the power of sin in our lives. God's power is mighty also in that it restores us to a right relationship with Him. God didn't save you to leave you where you are. God saved you to make you His and to lead you home to Jerusalem. So as we live this life, we think of Psalm 126 and the power of God to save us, and we're encouraged that He will indeed bring us home. Here's Psalm 126 for us from the English Standard Version. When the Lord restored the fortunes of Zion, we were like those who dream. Then our mouths were filled with laughter, and our tongue with shouts of joy. Then they said among the nations, "The Lord has done great things for them. The Lord has done great things for us, and we are glad. Restore our fortunes, O Lord, like streams in the Negev. Those who sow in tears shall reap with shouts of joy. He who goes out weeping, bearing the seed for sowing, shall come home with shouts of joy, bringing his sheaves with him." Indeed, in the grace and mercy of God, we will participate in the wonderful harvest of bounty in His grace. Be encouraged, friends, to walk with Him. Follow Him and cry out to Him to restore to you the joy of your salvation. Have a great day. I'll catch you tomorrow.